Hello everyone, so in this lecture we'll see different kinds of problems based on flow control policies. In flow control policies we discussed three protocols. First one, stop and wait. Then in the sliding window protocol we have seen go back n and selective repeat. Okay guys, so let us begin with the first problem. So today we'll see some good problems based on the flow control policies, isn't it? And these are very, very important. We'll see some gate problems also, previous year gate problems, isn't it? So whatever I discussed in the theory part of flow control policies, so today we'll see numericals based on that, isn't it? So if you covered all the flow control policies, then easily you can solve these questions, isn't it? Okay. The first question is given to you, that is, if 6-bit sequence number is used, isn't it? That means what? The number of bits in the sequence number fields are 6 bits. And question is, maximum sender window size and receiver window size possible in case of first one GBN and second one is selective repeat, isn't it? So listen me correctly guys, we'll see one by one. So first one, that is go back n, isn't it? Question is, we need to find the sender window size. So you know number of bits, let's say k equals to 6 bits, isn't it? So number of sequence numbers, or we can say that different sequence numbers possible, different sequence numbers possible with these 6 bits, that will be equals to 2^6. That means 64 sequence numbers can be generated. Now you know if 64 sequence numbers are there, then you know in case of GBN or sender's window size, let's say this is 64, that is n, isn't it? Or different sequence numbers are, let's say, capital N. So you know sender window size will be what? N minus 1, that is 64 minus 1, that is 63. And receiver's window size is fixed in case of GBN, isn't it? You know, yeah, sender window size plus receiver window size is always less than equals to available sequence number. So here available sequence number is 64. So maximum sender window size possible is 63 and receiver window size is fixed in GBN, isn't it? So first we can say that maximum sender window size possible, that is 63, isn't it? And a receiver window size is fixed in GBN, that is always 1. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Now in the second part, that is selective repeat. Selective repeat. So you know in selective repeat, remember this thing. Yes, in case of selective repeat, you know sender window size is always less equals to receiver window size. And in the sliding window protocol, you know this relation, sender window size plus receiver window size is always less than equals to available sequence number. So you know, yes, you only tell me sender window size plus receiver window size. Now you only tell me available sequence numbers are here 64, isn't it? That is given. So we can say that that must be equal to sender window size plus receiver window size. Here I am putting equal to sign because that is given, 64, isn't it? Isn't it 64? So the sum of sender window size plus receiver window size could be less than equals to 64. But here he is asking maximum sender window size and a receiver window size. That's why I taking equal to sign, isn't it? Okay, I am trying to get the maximum size of the sender and receiver window size, isn't it? Now sender window size, let's say that is n, and receiver window size is also n, isn't it? Why? Because in case of selective repeat, both sender and receiver window are equal. That is equals to 64. Here n is what? Sender window size. I am assuming that here capital N represents the sender window size. So that will be equal to 2N equals to 64. So N will be what? 32. So we can say that yes, sender window size will be 32 as well as receiver window size will be 32. I hope this one is clear to everyone. So from this question, you can say that you can conclude one point. You can note it down. First one, in GBN, we can say that sender window size, that is sender window size is less than 2 raised to power k, where k is what? K is the sequence number bits, isn't it? So here we can say that sequence number bits. So here k value is what? K value is given to you 6. So sender window size will be strictly less than 2 raised to power 6. So sender window size is less than 64. So to get the maximum sender window size, we can take it to 63. Similarly, in second point for selective repeat, a maximum, or we can say that sender window size is less than equals to 2 raised to power k minus 1. Isn't it? So sender window size will be less than equals to 2 raised to power 6 minus 1. That is, sender window size will be less than equals to 2 raised to power 5, that is 32. So maximum, for maximum we can take 32. And you know one more property, sender window size is equals to receiver window size in selective repeat. The second point is for selective repeat. So you can remember these points. Isn't it? Okay, I hope this one is clear to everyone. So moving to the next question, that is question number 2. Question number 2. Yes, that is the question number 2. If maximum sender window in selective repeat is n, the number of bits required for the sequence number field will be. Now you know, yes, in case of selective repeat protocol, sliding window protocol, or in any sliding window protocol, we can say that sender window size plus receiver window size is always less than equals to available sequence numbers, isn't it? So here, how many sequence numbers will be there? Here, nothing is given about the sequence number. We need to find it, isn't it? So you know, sender window size is 4, so that is 4. Receiver window size is always equal to sender window size in selective repeat. You know very well, sender window size is equals to receiver window size. That must be less than equals to available sequence number. So 8 less than equals to available sequence number. So from here we can conclude at least how many sequence numbers are required. At least, yes, 8 sequence numbers are required. Isn't it? At least 8 sequence numbers are required. If 8 sequence numbers are required, then how many number of bits will be required? So we can say that the number of bits will be log, yes, 8 base 2, and take the seal value, that is 3. So 3 bits are required, because with the help of 3 bits we can generate 8 different sequence numbers like this: 000, 001, 010, 011, and up to all ones. You can see 8 numbers can be generated with the help of these 3 bits. So in the sequence number field of the header, yes, there will be, or they require space of 3 bits. And with the help of these 3 bits, we can generate 8 different sequence numbers. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Otherwise, I have given you the formula: number of bits, a number of sequence numbers in case of selective repeat equals to 2n. And to find the number of bits, we can take the log 2n base 2 and take the seal value. And here, n value is what? 4. So 2 into 4, that will be the 8. Directly you can use this formula, isn't it? In the last lecture, I have given these formulas also. I hope this one is clear to everyone. That was the second question. So moving to the next one. Yes, that is the third question. It is important one. In selective repeat sliding window protocol, if bandwidth is 100 Mbps, round trip time, RTT stands for round trip time, and round trip time is what? Twice of propagation time. That is given to you 25 microseconds, and data packet size is equals to 10 bits, then find out sender's window size and number of bits are required for sequence number field. That is the question. This one is important one, isn't it? So you know, yes, you only tell me. So window size will be, first question we'll see, that will be equals to 1 plus 2a, and a is what? That is pt upon tt. So here pt, what will be the pt? RTT is twice of pt, so pt will be RTT divided by 2. So 25 by 2, that will be equals to 12.5 microseconds, isn't it? Now what will be the TT? TT is the data size, that is L, 10 upon bandwidth, so that is 100 into 10 raised to power 6 bits per second, and this is bits, isn't it? So after calculating this one, we will be getting, yes, you only tell me. We can say that what will be the TT? So we can say that this one will be the 10 raised to power 8 minus 8, 10 raised to power minus 7 seconds. So we can say that this one will be 0.1 into 10 raised to power minus 6 seconds, and that will be the 0.1 microseconds. Micro means 10 raised to power minus 6. Because PT is in microseconds, so try to make TT also in microseconds, isn't it? So what will be the PT? PT 12.5 microseconds, TT will be the 0.1, so that will be 125. So 1 plus 2 into 125, that will be the 251. So what will be the answer? Yeah, sender window size will be the 251. That will be the answer. Now you only tell me, this is the sliding window, selective repeat is given to you. So in selective repeat, sender window size is always equals to receiver's window size, isn't it? So next question, we can say that sender window size is 251. So receiver window size will also be 251. So you know, sender window size plus receiver window size is less than equals to available sequence numbers. We are 251 plus 251, yes, less than equals to available sequence numbers. Now that will be 502, must be less than equals to available sequence number. So minimum, how many sequence numbers are required? Minimum, or at least we can say that at least 502 sequence numbers are required. 502. Isn't it? Because 502 is less than equals to 502. So at least how many sequence numbers are required? 502. So those many sequence numbers are required. These are the different sequence numbers. And to generate these 502 sequence numbers, how many bits are required in the sequence number field of the header? So that will be the log 502 base 2 and take the seal value. So it is going to be 9, so 9 bits are required. Otherwise, you can use this formula log 2n base 2, take the seal value in selective repeat. So n value is what? 251. So 251 into 2, that will be the 502 only. Isn't it? Directly you can apply this formula. Isn't it? I hope this one is clear to everyone. Isn't it? Okay, so moving to the next problem. That is question number 4. What is given? Consider an error-free 128 kbps satellite. Remember, if it is written kbps, small b means bits, isn't it? Sometimes it is written kbps, so capital B means what? Bytes. So be careful, guys, isn't it? Small b means bits and capital B means bytes, isn't it? is used to send 256 bytes of data frames. The frames or packets, we'll see when it is called frames, when it is called a datagram, when it is called packet, isn't it? Data frame means one data packet, isn't it? For the time being, you can remember, frame means a packet only, nothing else. In one direction, with very short acknowledgement coming back the other way, and what is the maximum throughput for window size of 2? Assume that propagation time is 200 milliseconds. So the data given is, bandwidth is given, that is 128 kbps. Second one, data size, that is L, length, data size or length, isn't it? That is 256 of bytes. Be careful, isn't it? And window size is given to you. Window size, let's say that is capital N, that is given to you 2, isn't it? And propagation time is also given, that is propagation delay, that is 200 milliseconds. Now question is, what is the maximum throughput, isn't it? First find out the efficiency. Efficiency will be the N upon 1 plus 2A in case of, yes, we can say that sliding window protocols, isn't it? Isn't it? No need to worry about that. Okay. Next one, we can say that that is efficiency. So here N is what? Window size. So window size is what? 2 divided upon 1 plus 2. A means PT upon TT. And PT is given to you 200 milliseconds. And what will be the TT? So TT, yes, find out the TT. TT will be the data size. That is 256 bytes, so convert it into bits, divided by bandwidth, that is 128 into 10 raised to power 3 bits per second, isn't it? So after calculating, you will see TT will be what? 16 into 10 raised to power 3 seconds, so it will be 16 milliseconds. So both PT and TT must be in the same units, isn't it? Then only we can divide. So from here, after calculating this one, you will be getting 1 upon 13. So what will be the throughput? Yes, you only tell me, guys. Throughput will be the efficiency into bandwidth. So efficiency is 1 upon 13 into bandwidth is 128 kbps. So it is going to be 9.85 kbps. Isn't it? Okay. So we can say that. That is the throughput, isn't it? So throughput is what? 9.85 kbps, isn't it? Okay guys, so this was the fourth question, that was the important one. So that is clear. I hope this one is clear to everyone. So moving to the next one, question number 5, that is the previous year gate problem. So station A needs to send a message consisting of 9 packets to station B using sliding window. With window size 3 and GBN policies applied, go back and all packets are ready and immediately available for transmission. If every 5th packet get lost, but no ACK from B ever get lost here, then what is the number of packets that A will transmit for sending the message to B? Options are given to you. So these type of questions I also covered in the theory lectures, isn't it? And I hope this one it will be clear to everyone. There won't be any problem, isn't it? Window size is 3. In total, 9 packets are there. And every 5th packet get lost. Then total transmissions will be how many? That is the question. Options are given to you. First one is 12. Second one is 14. Third one is 16. Fourth one is 18. Isn't it? So let me see it once. Let's say, yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 packets are there. So 5th packet get lost. So this is 5th one. So window size is 3. So during this time period, when 5th get lost, then window contains 6 and 7 as well. So when 5th get lost in GBN, then 6th and 7th will be discarded. And entire window will be retransmitted. That is the concept. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 get lost, then 6th and 7th will be discarded, again transmit entire window 5, 6, 7. Now count from here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again fifth packet is lost. Now you only tell me when fifth this one get lost, then window contains 7, 8, 9. So again we need to retransmit entire window. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 5, 6. Now 7 get lost, this 7th one, and 8 and 9th will be discarded because in GBN, yes, in order packets are received only. Again, retransmit 7, 8, 9. Now counting will start from here, and why I explained in the theory lecture. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, this 5th one get lost. Now no packet is there in the queue because total 9 packets are there. So again retransmit this one. Now there will be a successful transmission. So count how many transmissions were required. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So correct answer will be, guys, 16. 16 will be the correct answer. I hope this one is clear to everyone, isn't it? So which one is correct? We can say that yes, C, option C, that is the correct answer. Isn't it? That was the gate question. Next one. Yes, that is question number 6. That is also a gate question. Consider a selective repeat sliding window protocol that uses a frame size of 1 kilobyte. Isn't it? 1 kilobyte. Capital B is there. So remember that is kilobyte, not kilobit. Isn't it? To send data on a 1.5 Mbps link. Isn't it? 1.5 Mbps link. Here B is small, so bit. With a one-way latency, that means propagation delay is 50 milliseconds. So to achieve a link utilization of 60%, the minimum number of bits required to represent the sequence number field is. Isn't it? So link utilization means ultimately efficiency. So here efficiency is given to you 60%. Isn't it? And we need to find out the number of bits for the sequence number field. Isn't it? So we'll see one by one. First, we'll see what will be the window size. Isn't it? If window size is clear to you, then we easily, or we can say that if we can find out the window size, so with the help of window size, we can find out the number of sequence numbers. And once we get the sequence numbers, then we can take the log and we can find out the number of bits, isn't it, to represent the different sequence numbers, isn't it? So what is the data given? So here PT is what? Propagation delay, that is 50 milliseconds. Bandwidth given, that is 1.5 into 10 raised to power 6 bits per second. And data packet size is what? Packet size is, we can say that what is given, packet size 1 kilobyte, that is 10 raised to power 3 into 8 bits because it is given in the bytes, isn't it? So what will be the efficiency? Efficiency will be n upon 1 plus 2a, that is given to you, that is 60%, then 60 by 100, isn't it? Now PT is given to you, so A is PT upon TT. So we need to find out the TT. TT will be what? A data size, that is 10 raised to power 3 into 8 bits upon bandwidth, that is 1.5 into 10 raised to power 6 bits per second. So evaluate this one, TT. So TT will be 5.3 into 10 raised to power minus 3 seconds. So we can say that that is 5.3 milliseconds. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay. So put these values. So n upon 1 plus 2 into PT is what? 50 millisecond upon TT is 5.3 millisecond. Units are same, equals to 60 by 100. So from here we can say that n equals to 0.6. This is 0.6 into 1 plus 100 divided by 5.3. So this is going to be 0.6 into 105.3 divided by 5.3. So it is going to be 11.9. So this is the window size. So sender window size is equals to receiver window size. So here sender window size will be 11.9 and receiver window size will also be 11.9. So sender window size plus receiver window size will be less than equals to available sequence number. So that will be 11.9 plus 11.9 less than equals to available sequence number. So it is going to be 23.8 or less than equals to available sequence number. So at least how many sequence numbers are required? Yes, 23.8 sequence numbers are required. Isn't it? At least 23.8 sequence numbers are required. Isn't it? So how many bits will be required for this one? 23.8 base 2 and take the seal value. This is going to be 5. 5 will be the correct answer. Isn't it? Otherwise you can take, yes, this value is n, so directly take log 2n base 2. Isn't it? From here you can find out that will be the 5. Isn't it? Otherwise you can apply this formula also. Sender window size in selective repeat is less than equals to 2 raised to power k minus 1. Here k value will be 5, then only we can say that this one is what? 11.9 less than equals to 2 raised to power 5 minus 1. 11.9 will be less than equals to 2 raised to power 4, that is 16. So minimum we can say that, yes, k value required, that is 5. Isn't it? Okay. So I hope this one is clear to everyone. So these were the some mixed questions based on the flow control policies. In this manner, you can find the solution of each and every problem. Isn't it? So guys, I hope this one is clear to everyone. Isn't it? Okay. Okay guys, so in the next lecture, we'll see some different topic. Isn't it? So flow control policies are, we can say that, finished out. Isn't it? With the exam. Okay guys, thank you so much.